Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. Remember our video where we walked you through creating a brand new and absolutely free website? Now that your website is up and running, you might be wondering, can people actually find it on Google? Is my website getting any views? Well, guess what? I have got the answers to those burning questions, and today we are diving into solutions to clear up any confusion that you might have. So, we are about to show you how to get your website noticed on Google in a flash and keep track of how it is doing. Here is a breakup on what we will cover in this video. Firstly, we'll check if your website is already showing on Google by using site operator in Google search. And if it is not there yet, no worries, we have got your back. We will show you how to upload a sitemap to Google Search Console using two easy methods. You can choose the one that works best for you. Next, we'll dive into Google Analytics. We will walk you through linking your account and reveal how to keep tab on your website's visibility. You will know who is visiting, what they're interested in, and all that good stuff. By now, your website would be waving hello to Google search results. But if it is not the case, don't worry, we have got more tips and tricks for you. Ever thought about having a Google business page? We will show you how, and trust me, it is a game changer for boosting your online presence. But wait, that's not enough. We will be doing a thorough check of your website to make sure it's all set. We're talking about security checks, compatibility across different devices like laptops and mobiles, and a trick to make certain pages index upon the Google. And finally, your website would be shining bright on Google. But hang on, we are not done yet. If you want your website to rule the first page, we have got you covered. We will reveal the secrets of crafting a top-notch content that will make your website the star of the show. So let's get started. It's the time to unlock the secrets of Google visibility and take your website from zero to hero. So let's start by checking if my website is visible on Google. For this, we have to write site colon your website name. I am taking example of BuzzHats in this video. So let's write it. Site colon buzzhats.com. So you can see that there are zero results. It means that website is not visible on Google. If someone goes directly by my website name, that is buzzhats.com, then only it would be visible. But that would not come in regular Google search results. So, this will not be of any benefit for us until it ranks in Google search. So, next step would be to make it searchable on Google. For this, we would add sitemap to Google Search Console. Now, you must be thinking, what is a sitemap? So, think of it as a master list of all the pages living in your website. Now, we want to give Google the heads up when we add new page so that it can showcase them. But how does Google do it? It does it by sending crawlers, which are like internet bots, to our website to read what's there and make it searchable. By adding a sitemap, we are basically rolling out a red carpet for those crawlers, guiding them to every page and not letting any page get lost in the shuffle. So let's dive in and first add our website to Google Search Console. Then we will add the sitemap. So let's go to this link, try Google Search Console. Click on Start now. Sign in from your email ID. Now, go to left hand side and click on Add Property. Now write the domain name and remove HTTPS from here. Continue. It will verify the property. Now it will give us steps that what needs to be done next. So we have to go to our domain name provider and then copy this text below in the DNS configuration. So let's go to domain name provider, login. So in our case, it is Hostinger. So let's log in into it. Enter your email ID password. Go to domains, then go to BuzzHats manage. Now go to DNS/nameservers in the left menu. Yes. Here you will be looking at manage DNS records. So select TXT over here. In the text value, copy the value from here. And paste over here. In the name, don't put anything. Just leave it as it is and add record. So DNS record has been created successfully. Now you can go back to Google Search Console and click on Verify. Yes, so it has been verified. So now our account is linked with the Google Search Console. Now let's add sitemap to this for crawling. So the first method is to search for creating the sitemap. Click on the first link, enter the link of your own website and click on start. It will take a few minutes. Now it is ready. Click on View Sitemap Details and you can download a XML sitemap file from here. Just click on it to open it and see what's in there. So here you will see it has the location LOC, which has the link to a website, then when it was modified last and priority, and it has various links, all the links actually which are there on your website. So you have to upload it in the domain root folder and then open Google Search Console and upload. So firstly, let's go on HPanel right now and upload it in the domain root folder. So go to manage. The file section will be there. Yeah, here it is. Click on file manager, access files of buzz hats. Click on it. Then you can add in public HTML over here. Upload file. Now when this is done, you need to go back to Google Search Console. And in the left menu, go to sitemaps and paste the URL over here where the sitemap has been uploaded and click on start. As of now, it will give us error, could not fetch, because we have not actually uploaded the file in that root folder. So now let's see what is the method number 2 for doing the same thing. Go to HPanel, edit website. Yes, go to plugins, add new. From here, just search the plugin Yoast SEO. Install this. It is installed now. Let's activate it. It is activated, so let's click on it. Yeah, click on first time configuration. And you need to fill in the details if required, otherwise just click on continue for all the things if it is correct. Save and continue. You can add social profiles over here. As of now, I'm skipping it. If you want to track your own data, you can click on no. Then just finish the configuration and go to your SEO dashboard. So it will create the sitemap at this default URL. buzzhat/sitemap_index. So just copy it and paste it over here in the Google Search Console. So you'll see success over here. So here 24 pages are discovered and our sitemap has been submitted. Now that we have added the sitemap to Google Search Console, the crawlers will crawl it in a day or two. Then your website will start getting visible on Google search results. You can check again by using the site operator. But it will not show how many views came to your website. To know that, you need to set up Google Analytics account to know more about your visitors. So let's get started with this. Just write Google Analytics on the Google search. Click on the first link. Yes, so here in settings, you can see create property, write the name of your website, select the reporting zone and currency, choose industry size and industry type, next. Then what is your business objective? You can choose from here. So as of now, I'm selecting this generate leads only. Wait. Let's skip it for now. And you are here. Now set up the data collection. It will take us back to the data streams. Yes. So let's do for website. Click on website. Then write down the website URL over here. Here in the stream name, you can write in. So now it is giving us measurement ID. We need to add this in our domain name provider. So let's go back to HPanel, go to plugins and install the Google Sitemap from here. Click on activate. Let's start the setup. Now select these options and click with sign in with Google. choose your account and give them the access. So just click on next over here. We are already verified. Click on next again because they have the access to our data. It is already added to Search Console. So next, and let's set up the Google Analytics. Let it load. Yeah, so here we can see that it is giving me the same tag ID. So just click on Configure Analytics. And yes, it's done. So it's that easy. So method 2 is very easy if you are having the website on WordPress. But if you're not having it, then we have other methods too. So here we can see the data. It will start populating in a day or two. So just be patient with it. Now here, if you click on View Tag Instructions, then you can see the steps also. So here it is also given installed manually. So if you're not using a WordPress website, then you can just copy and paste this code on every page of your website after the head element. And we have to add only one Google tag on one page. If you're using another plugin like WooCommerce plugin, so you can click over here and see the instructions related to it. We also have Sitekit plugin instruction over here. So you can follow this. You can now also go back to the Google Analytics and see that it is also using the same tag ID and data will start populating in a day or two. So now with Google Analytics, we will be able to keep the track of the customers that visit our website. If your website is not visible in Google search results, there is one more easy and effective way to make it visible. Just make a Google business page for your business. You can do this by searching My Business on Google or going to the link mentioned on the screen and fill in your business details. And your business and website would be visible in Google Search and Google Maps. I will be covering this in detail in the next video. This has many benefits. It makes your business highly visible as the business pages occupy quite significant space on Google Search. It helps you in ranking on the top of Google results. Apart from Google Search results, it also provides you visibility on Google Maps. Also, it is very easy to use and above all, it is free to use. You can also manage chats, have reviews through this, which is very useful nowadays, as everyone looks for reviews before investing their money. If a website is still not ranking, then we should check for the SSL security for your website. This is very important in case you are handling payments through your website. You can check this by opening your website, write down the website name, and click on the leftmost side of your website's URL. There should be lock over here. If it is there, this means that your website is on HTTPS and is using SSL. This is good to go. If it is not using SSL, we should make it follow this. In my video, step-by-step guide how to make a free website, I have told you how can we do this for free website. For paid domains, mostly it is already included in the package. You just need to activate it if not done. Now, the next step is to check if your website is compatible across the desktops and mobiles. For this, you can go to Google Search Console again and click on Mobile Usability. So here you will be seeing the number of pages which are not usable on mobile and the number of pages usable for mobile. So ideally, the number of pages which are not usable on mobile should be zero. Another method of doing this is go to Page Speed Insights and write down your website name over here and click on Analyze. It will fetch the performance data of both mobile and desktop. You can see it over here. It also gives a suggestion what needs to be done to improve this score. So here we can see that if on mobile we have a very bad score. Actually, it should be in green always. So let's see if we elevate my skill. So we can see that for mobile, everything is in green. It still gives the suggestions to improve the score. So we should be following that. Now, there might be cases when a website has started showing up on the Google search results, but there are still few pages which are not showing. For handling this, you can submit those URLs to add them to the priority list of crawling by following this method. For this, go to Google Search Console, paste the URL which you want to get indexed instantly. Now click on Request Indexing. Now it has added the URL to the priority crawling queue. Just click on got it. If you want to add more URLs, you can add it through this method. After following all these steps, your website would be ranking for sure on the Google search results. You can also check it by Google Analytics as told before. Also, you can use the site operator again. Here, you can see that it is showing about 9 results. So yes, it has started crawling. It will take some more time to crawl all the pages. So let's wait for that. But mind it, this is not the end of the game, as your website should rank on the first page to get the most out of it. For this, you need to ensure that you have enough content on your website. Also, the content should be unique and should be adding value to the customers. Not only this, there are 4 parts of SEO, that is search engine optimization, that you should be following to rank on the top. The 4 parts are, first is doing keyword research to understand which keywords are most searched and should be included in your content. Second is making sure that your page gets good points on page speed insights website. In technicality and other technical things are taken care of. Third is on-page SEO and last is off-page SEO, which includes link building and social media management. I have made a video on keyword research process and the tools used for it. I have provided the link in the description below. You can watch it. For the 3 other topics, I'll be making the video soon. So that's all from my side. If you want to watch more content in future, do not forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more such content. Hit the notification bell so you never miss an update. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.